Edwin Powell Hubble was born in Marshfield, Missouri in November of 1890. His father worked his way up the ladder in the insurance industry and owned a large fruit farm. Hubble's father frequently traveled for business, so he did not have much of a relationship with him. His grandfather may have been responsible for some of Edwin's inspiration, as he believed that the most beautiful things in the universe were the planets and the stars. As an adult, Edwin lost touch with his family. He married Grace Leeb in 1924, but they had no children. In 1949, Hubble suffered a major heart attack and passed away 4 years later of a cerebral thrombosis. His remains were cremated and the ashes were buried in a secret location with his wife when she passed away. No one knows the location of these remains. In World War I, Hubble joined the Officers' Reserve Corps, was promoted to major, and trained soldiers going overseas. In World War II, he headed R&D on the trajectory of artillery because he had a reputation for controlling theory with observation, a quality that played an important role in his research as a scientist. Throughout his career, he received many awards for both his work as an astronomer and his service in the military. Edwin excelled in sports. He was literate before he started grammar school, and one of his teachers predicted that he would be one of the most brilliant men of his generation. He attended the University of Chicago, where he wanted to study astronomy. His father wanted him to become a lawyer, so Edwin studied both fields to delay making a decision between the two disciplines, hoping that his father would change his mind, although he never did. During his final year at Oxford, his father passed away. Edwin returned home upon graduating, and being unsuccessful at law, became a teacher. The following year, Edwin was back at the University of Chicago studying astronomy, where he would earn his PhD. Upon the start of World War I, he rushed the completion of his dissertation to serve his country. As Edwin began his career in astronomy, he entered a torn field. Astronomers argued with one another on the makings of the universe. On one side were the astronomers who believed that the universe only consisted of the Milky Way galaxy. Opposing that theory was the island theory, which stated that the universe was comprised of many galaxies. By the early 1930s, Edwin had made 4 major contributions to the field of astronomy. He created a classification system that is still used today. His famous H335H image confirmed that the Andromeda Nebula was indeed a galaxy outside of the Milky Way, shattering the theory that the universe only consisted of the Milky Way galaxy. He also discovered the relationship between the redshift of a nebula's spectra and its distance from the Earth. Further, by studying the velocity-distance relationship, Hubble's culminating work showed that the universe was expanding. Hubble did not let his feelings or opinions get in the way of his observations or analysis. He once said his goal was to discover all possible about nebulae and their relation to stars. He formed his theories based off an analysis of what the data showed, contrary to other scientists of the time who preferred to fit the data to their beliefs. His classification system was a way to sort nebulae to systemize data until a theory of the makings of the universe could be decided upon. Because of this, he sent it to the International Astronomical Union to adopt. They refused because they believed it sided with the opposing controversial island theory. Once word got out of Hubble's findings, he was told to reconsider his data and force it to fit the existing theory that the universe was only made out of the Milky Way galaxy. Instead, Hubble continued to collect data to prove his theory, delaying publication. When Hubble determined the relationship between distance and redshift, he wanted to collect additional data to confirm his results. But out of fear of his work being stolen, he published and continued to collect data. He republished his findings from the data he had collected 2 years later. Hubble is now considered one of the greatest astronomers of all time. His constant in the velocity-distance equation he found was later named the Hubble constant. He grew to great fame during his lifetime when Einstein publicly stated that Hubble's findings of the expanding universe supported his general theory of relativity. Within the scientific community, however, there were those who did not like Hubble. Hubble's work profoundly expanded scientists' understanding of the known universe. His persistent methods demonstrate the importance of using data alone to generate a theory, instead of using the data to fit an existing theory. Hubble was always willing to take the data for its word, even if it meant going against one of his original findings. His goal was to promote our understanding of the universe as much as possible by exploring the deepest portions of space. His findings are still valid today and taught in astronomy classes all over the world.